Today I'd like to have a look at thread measurement using the three-wire method, and I thought I'd start with showing a picture of how it's done. So I've drawn this picture of a thread up. In this case, we're going to use an example of a 7/8 outside diameter thread, 9 threads the inch, and it'll be a unified coarse thread. The fit will be 2A. And what we've done is we have put some section lines in to indicate the cross section of the thread or where it's being cut down the middle to make the picture more clear. The blue lines indicate the pitch diameter of the thread, which is a space approximately halfway between the top of the thread and the bottom of the thread. It is in fact a place where the thickness of the thread equals the space in between. And if we measure across to the other thread on the bottom, that becomes the pitch diameter of the thread. We're going to set wires into the thread, and the idea is that we want them to meet or touch at the pitch diameter. And we want the top of the wire to extend slightly beyond the outside of the thread so we can actually measure over it. And that's what's happening in this picture. Now, in order to choose the wire for this thread to measure it, there's a couple of formulas we're going to look at. The largest wire we can use formula is 1.010 divided by the number of threads per inch. The smallest wire we could use is 0.505 divided by the number of threads per inch. In a perfect world, the wire we would choose, the formula is 0.57735 divided by the number of threads per inch. If we use that calculation, the best wire we could put in this thread to measure it would be 64 thousandths of an inch in diameter. So in other words, we would choose three wires that are 64 thousandths of an inch in diameter. The thread wire set has many different wires with three of identical wires per pouch. The closest match we have to that 64 thou we require is actually 63 thou. If you were to calculate the largest wire we can use and the smallest wire we can use, the 63 thou wire will fall within that range, so we're good to use it. Now that we have the wires picked out and set into the thread and it'll contact at the pitch diameter, we can actually do a calculation so we can measure over the outside of these wires with the micrometer. Please notice in this picture here, the wires are actually bigger than the outside diameter of this thread, or we wouldn't be able to measure it. The formula to check this measurement is M is equal to D plus 3G minus 1.5155 divided by the number of threads per inch. M is the measurement over the wire. D is the nominal diameter of the thread, in this case it's 7/8 of an inch. Plus 3G. The G is the actual wire we're using. In this case it'll be 63 thou. Minus 1.5155 divided by N, which is the number of threads per inch. In this case it is 9 threads per inch. If we do this calculation, it rounds to three decimal places to 0.895 inches. 895 thou is slightly larger than the outside diameter of this thread, which is 875 thou. So we can clearly measure over the outside of these wires to get the measurement. Here's a list of three-wire formulas that are used in both the unified inch system and the metric system for measuring thread pitch diameters. The largest wire is 1.010, either divided by N in the unified inch system or times pitch, P, in the metric system. We'll look at the ones divided by N because that's the example that was given. So as long as the diameter of the wire falls between the largest wire size, 1.010 inches divided by N, or between 0.505 divided by N, as long as the wire falls between those two sizes, we can use it. In a perfect scenario, we would like to have a best wire size of 0.57735 divided by N. In the example of the 7/8 diameter, 9 threads to the inch, the best wire would be 64 thousandths of an inch. We'll then go to a pitch diameter wire set and we'll pick out three identical diameter wires. The closest one to 64 thou is actually 63 thou, and that will fall between the largest and smallest wire, so we can use that wire. We will now then go to the measure over the wires. So the M value in the inch system is equal to D, which is nominal diameter, 0.875. Never use actual diameter size, always use nominal diameter. Plus 3G, G is the actual wire we're using. In this case, it's 363 thou wires that we'll set into the thread. Minus 1.5155 divided by N, number of threads per inch. That will give us a diameter of 0.895 inches, rounded to three decimal places. Please note that that size is measured over the wires, which is larger than the outside diameter of the thread, allowing us to use these wires to take a measurement. There will be a tolerance on the fit of the pitch diameter, depending on the fit of the thread. Let's say for argument's sake you have a tolerance of 5 thou, so the 0.895 inches will actually be maximum diameter, and you could be as small as 5 thou under that, 0.890, and that would be acceptable. The fit of the thread will be found in the machinery handbook, where you will find the tolerances. Before we measure the thread, we actually want to make sure we have the right outside diameter, assuming you're checking a thread rather than cutting it. And we want to check the threads per inch. So in this case, we have a 7/8 diameter thread with 9 threads to the inch. Here's a set of thread wires we're going to use, and this package has several different selection of wires we can use. And there are 3 wires of the same diameter, and there are several different diameters. We're going to use the 3 that are 63 thousandths of an inch in diameter. What you want to do, put a micrometer over it to make sure they are all the same size. In other words, that somebody hasn't accidentally put it in the wrong pouch. Now, these are actually 63 thou. Again, with the calculation we did, we found that 64 thou was the best choice wire to use. But this is the wire we actually have in the set, is a 63 thou wire. As long as it falls between the largest wire and the smallest wire, we can use it. And it's very, very close to the best wire size. Again, this one is 63 thou in diameter, 3 of them. And the best wire would have been 64 thou. So what we'll do is we'll take these 363 thousandths of an inch wires and we'll actually set them into the thread. And I want to make sure that we're setting it into the thread right next to each other. And I like to set 2 wires on top. Now, because this is a right-handed thread, we have a spiral going clockwise towards the back of the thread. And I'm just going to take this wire and I'm going to push it up against the back wire. And then I'll pull it down and I'll let it sit in between the 2 wires. I'm going to take the micrometer open slightly larger than we need, and I'm going to have the bottom of the micrometer or the anvil sit on the bottom wire. And then what we'll do is we'll tighten it down until it just comes into contact with the top wires, and then we'll use the ratchet stop to give it a couple of clicks. We'll lock the micrometer. I'm going to cup my hand so we can catch all the wires as they come off. And here's the reading on the micrometer taken over the wires. Again, please note it is larger than the outside diameter of the thread, which was 0.875 inches. And it actually is very, very close, 0.895 inches. It's just slightly smaller than that, so it's quite acceptable.